the people, or I will say maybe the incumbent, because I will, those people are mostly going for the incumbent. But this denies the ground, the people, the chance to actually have their say in their locality, right? So when you have such massive importation of voters, when the figures don't make sense, like you see the capacity of each stream. If I ask you a question, how long would it take, even with just an ID, for one person to actually physically vote, get in, get checked, even just your ID, leave alone the repertory register, take up the several slips, okay, mark them, and move out of the room? How long, Samuel, I will challenge you, would it take one person? I want you to ask you to do the math so that you understand the amount of rigging that was going on. Now, if I ask you, how long will it take?
Maybe 1 minute at most.
1 minute at most. If it's 1 minute at most, 1 minute is very small. It's actually, let's say, the minimum. Right? So in 1 hour, how many people can vote?
60.
How many hours is this particular election going on? Right?
Yes.
You'd find that it's maybe 10 hours. Right. So 60 times 10, it makes it how much?
6,000.
600.
600, I mean.
600. And a minute is too little. You cannot have checked. No, it's about 3 minutes, actually. So 600, if you go at an extremely fast rate of a minute, you know, like magic, only a maximum of 600 people can vote. Now, one candidate reports in one particular polling station of getting 1,800 votes. Right?
Yes.
If we now put it into context, you would have to divide again by three this minute. Okay, into 20 seconds that one particular more person is getting checked ID, provided with these ballots,
yes.
They're stamped. They go to that private area,
they vote.
Mark five ballots, then move from that area, place each one in its particular box in 20 seconds.
That's not logic.
It's impossible. Right? So you can see that these figures don't make sense. If you went to the ODM one, you'd see a bit more set. The winner, or maybe for MCA, would be, it was maybe in Airbus, what I can say, it's 167, and the next one is 97. All right. This is closer to the truth. So there are six candidates. You'd have about a maximum of 600 votes totally cast. By the way, it's about, should be about reasonably 400 to 500.
Yes.
All right. The ABC figure for one line should be maximum 500. With a voter turnout of about 70% to 80%, that will be about 400 people voting. Right. This is what is reality. These other figures, is because we are too lazy to do the maths, are obviously stealing. Right. And these people steal and then cry that they've been robbed. I don't know where they get the moral temerity.
Yes.
To somebody says, I've been robbed. I won.
Yet he's the one who was robbed.
Yes, he's clearly robbed. Yes. All right. And now this, we are robbed of the legitimacy of a nomination. Right. And from there, this person is washed and becomes, now this is the result of an election that these people won. And you know how controversial it was. And Simon Mbugua had to give his nomination to Yusuf Hassan. I don't know why he needs it, because he's been an MP for 8 years.
Yes.
Now, I don't know what is remaining in his agenda to perform for us, because he had a 5-year plan, which I was supporting. And I voted in him for that particular plan. Those 5 years are done. Okay, he should give a chance to somebody else. And those things that were in that plan were completely forgotten. Completely forgotten.
So he has done nothing.
I will not say he's done nothing. No. But he is not performed to his promises. Right? He had promised the market will come back to the public. It never happened. Yeah. Yes? And to set up the carpet actually got started being built by private developers. Instead of it, of the coming back to the public, the private developers now actually started construction. All right?
Yes.
So the other promise was on roads, those particular roads that they're under the MP, with the national government. Most of the roads in Eastleigh are major roads, though they look maybe like dirt roads, right? Which when I was growing up, they're all tarmac roads. Having the problems you're having of water and drainage in Eastleigh, Cabro roads would be the best because they don't get destroyed by water, right? So how many roads have come up? Because this comes under Kura, and the MP has a representation under Kura, whatever. So I think that, not that he has not performed, but he has underperformed. He has underperformed. And he should let somebody else try.
Maybe on that note, since Eastleigh is Olalo zone.
Olalo. Yes.
Yeah. So maybe Somalis.
Yes.
I think the Somalis, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
So maybe what are your strategies for you to win an MCS seat? Maybe in 1 second, if you can just...
Okay, for starters, it's Somali, but also Muslim, let's say Muslim. And since I am directing, offering myself to the citizens, all right? And I'm a long-term resident. I have people who are familiar with me, and there are people who are not familiar with me, all right? So, but if I mount a strong enough campaign, which I am planning to do, meet at least 80% of the voters directly, I am sure, because people are attracted by people of knowledge and people of offering solutions. Somebody who can listen to a problem and actually offer a solution which is manageable within the purview that I'll be provided and asking for, right? So this is my main strategy. Get to everybody, talk to them, give them that choice. Because most people I know from experience, when they go to that hall, when they're ballot for MCAs, they know exactly nobody.
Other than Degwa John.
They usually will go for the big parties that gave president because they actually have been denied options by people not campaigning. Right? The people have not campaigned enough to raise their profile so that the voter can make an informed choice. So now, I will be going to each and every voter and giving them a choice of having to elect somebody they have met.
Yeah, and now, Honorable Ndegwa, just because of time, maybe in 1 minute time, you can ask for what's he there in Eastleigh to a resident who is seeing you, who is watching you.
Watu wa Eastleigh, mimi nauliza, Eastleigh tunatakaje? Ona. Kwa kweli, tumeona wale tumepatia wadhifa wa uongozi, wamekuwa na ubaguzi na mapendeleo. Na azma yangu, na ahidi. Hakuna ubaguzi. Natapea haki wa kila mtu katika ile nyadhifa mtanipa. Nitahakikisha sina ubaguzi. Sitabagua kabila wala rangi ya mtu wala we ni mke ama mume. Na sita kuahidi mambo haiwezekani. Kama iko kwa uwezo yangu, nitajaribu, tutajadiliana, tutajaribu vile itawezekana na tutatatua tatizo lile lilipo. Na hiyo ndiyo hadi yangu, nitakuwa wakujali, wakusikiza, na kuleta marekebisho. Tuweze kusonga mbele kiasi ya hoja kwa huo muda na fursa hiyo mtanipa. Hiyo ndio hiding. Na sitakuwa na mchezo mchezo kule ati naenda na hongo wa 20,000 ati nafanya governance siwezi angalia kitu governor amesema ama amefanya hajatekeleza wajibu wake alafu nacheka na yeye kwa sababu ati nimelambishwa. Siendi kutingisha mti kama raia yetu wengine ambao inachukulia ni kutingisha miti matunda yanguke wale. Nina uwezo mwenyewe, nina masomo. Hakuna ule ana masomo kuniliko, ule anaomba kiti ya MCA wala MP katika Kamkunji. Niko na masters ya geology, niko na degree ya zoology, ya chemistry.
Wow.
Kwa hivyo, sitalemewa na kusoma. Ati sitaelewa documents, discussions hizo zinaendelea. Governor ni mtu ako na degree, na unaona kwingi wameweza ma MCA kwa sababu ma MCA wanakuwa kiwango ya elimu ni chini sana. Lakini hiyo itafanyika na mimi. Nitaweza kujadiliana na governor na wenzangu kwa hekima na kwa hali ya waziwazi. Na nitangangana kabisa kuleta majibu yale napata kule mtaani. Sitawaambia ati mimi niotengeza barabara, nitaweleza ni governor kazi yake kutengeza barabara na tutafuatilia. Kuna pesa fulani zimetoka za hii barabara, inafaa kuanza siku fulani, ishe siku fulani.
Bwana Dego, natumai watu wa Isli wameweza kukusikiza. Lakini so, maybe swali ya mwisho kabla tufunge hiki kipindi, maybe you look so young. Yeah, so maybe where have you got the fundings for MCA?
Kwa kweli mimi si kijana mdogo. Mimi ni mtu mwanaume makamu. Lakini Mungu amenijalia afya. Nimekaa masomoni miaka mingi. Kidogo naye ananiregeshea na nipunguzia kwa sababu ya kung'ang'ana kuelewa vitu kidogo. Kampeni yangu number one si haina fedha mingi, na kazi yangu ile nafanya pale, mnajua mradi ile yangu ya maji, mimi nafanya kazi hapo, inanitosha kwa sababu napata ya mabango. Napata mimi islini ndogo, sihitaji gari, natembea kila mahali. Niko na watu wa kujitolea, na nyinyi nawaomba, ule mtu atembaye ataamua kunipigia kura na kunipa support, afuatilie mpaka ajitolee kuwa agent wangu, ndio tuweze kufanya mabadiliko. Na hii siasa ambaye ni ya udanganyifu, ya kufunika watu na pesa na hela kidogo kidogo, alafu tunapoteza ile mingi. Siwe watu wa kuuza urithi yetu kwa sahani ya dengu. Kama vile tunasoma Biblia pale, Esau aliuza urithi wake wa kuwa firstborn kwa sahani ya dengu, akisema ati atakufa siku hiyo. Hakuna. Sasa tunajibariki na Yakubu na familia yake, wala si yake. Na nawaomba tusikue hivyo. Kura kwa mkono yako ni haki Mungu amekupatia kubwa sana na nguvu kubwa kuchagua kiongozi wako mwenyewe.
That has been John Ndegwa, an aspirant MCA for Eastleigh North, and I believe Eastleigh residents, you have heard it for yourself. No one has, you have not heard from somewhere else. You have just heard right away from the source. So the ball is in your court. It's up to you to decide during the general election come August 8th this year. Remember, this has been MTN Breakfast Show. Remember, this is MTN Breakfast Show. And with me here is Samuel Kasuti. And remember to follow us on Twitter at MTN Kenya. Facebook is MTN Kenya. And Instagram is MTN Kenya. Remember to follow, to drop in your comments on 0701486625. And I've been with your guest here, John Ndegwa, an MCA aspirant. Remember, difficulties were not meant to discourage, but the human spirit grows strong by conflict. Keep it locked. Good day.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Kasuchi. Asante sana.
You are watching MTN Kenya, your number one favorite TV station.